what I can bring to the table is a case study. I actually do a lot of what Chris and John teach, and I can show you an actual case study. So I see comments, I see hands going up, and so I appreciate your responses there. So this won't take long. I can show you, though, what I'm doing with Google. So now, with Google, you know, here's how it works. I'll just go through it, and then I'll talk about the pros as we go. I think we all know how nice it is, how great it is to have really good rankings in Google, in the Google free results. Google traffic is very targeted. Once you get those solid rankings, the traffic comes in on an ongoing basis, and it's hands-free, high-quality traffic from one of the best sources in the world of traffic. So having that in place is great. But a lot of people have the question, how do I do that? How do I do that these days? So I have up another site of mine, betatips.com. So this is my site where I actually collect leads. This is where I build my list for the most part. When I'm going to tackle Google traffic, though, I'll build a second site, an authority site, like this one. And this is my authority site, betafishcenter.com. Now, I used a piece of software called the Authority Site Builder that I had created myself, spent several hundred thousand dollars getting this tool created, that enables me to create these really high-quality authority sites that Google loves. And I'm actually going to give you a chance to access that software and use it to create your own authority sites at the end of the call. Now, let's just take a look at how this site's performing, and I'll show you how I put it together in a matter of days. Now, I'm logged into my SEMrush account, which tracks rankings for this site. Took a quick screen grab. We have 166 top 10 rankings across various keywords in this niche. Get about 5,000 to 8,000 visitors per day from this site, per day from Google. From Google. That's a lot of traffic. So the key with Google, and this might be review for some of you, but I'll just talk about it quickly because it's important, is to make your site sticky. Google these days is all about content, and they're all about giving their visitors, their users, the best content possible. So when somebody goes to Google and types something in, say Beta Fish Care, Google wants to put the best sites at the top because then Google's giving people what they're looking for, and therefore people will continue to use Google. So you want to make your site sticky. Google is tracking how sticky your site is. If Google sends you a visitor, don't send that visitor back to Google. If Google sends you someone to your site, keep them there. If you send them back to Google, Google's tracking that. And they don't like it because it means that person didn't find what they were looking for on your site. So Google's tracking things specifically like this, how long people stay on our site and how many pages they visit. Those are two big ones. So getting people on your site, staying there, absorbing your content, and clicking around, those are the keys. Now, how do we do it? Good content organized well, number one, and then mechanisms to get people clicking around and absorbing your content. So let me show you how you can do this with the Authority Site Builder. And this isn't a demo for the Site Builder. I'm just going to show you the site and then how we do this with the site. But behind this is the Authority Site Builder serving this content up. So first off, on the homepage, we usually use an image gallery slider like this. So putting up big images, which are visually appealing and people can click in to various parts of the site. That gets people into the site. Moving on, having a forum feed. So we have a forum on the site. Forums can add a lot of benefit to your sites and get you a lot of traffic from Google. So having a forum feed on your homepage. And now, so this is just the latest posts from our forum. They're pulled into the homepage. People can click into those, and that gets them into the forum. Forums by nature are social. People click around, they post. Google's tracking how long people are there, how much they're clicking around. So forums help a lot. So moving on here, there's also a series of galleries that I've made sure to add to this site and all my authority sites. So it's important to have a variety of content on your site these days. The greater the variety of content, the better you'll do in Google. So I always make sure to have an article gallery, that's the learning gallery, a forum, that's the discussion gallery. The gallery tab leads to images, that's the image gallery, and then finally a video gallery, content, discussion, images, videos. Great content organized well. So let's go into the article gallery. This is a list of links to different articles. If we click on one of those, here's one of the articles. Now, all the pieces of content that go on our authority sites need to be quality pieces of content. Unfortunately, we can't get away with anything less these days if we really want to do well in Google. So this article is well written, and it covers the topic in detail. You want to make sure that your content is comprehensive, meaning that if you write an article on beta diseases, touch on all the key points of beta diseases. Don't just give an overview. Make sure to touch on the key points. Make sure it's comprehensive, like it covers the topic in detail and all the key areas of the topic. Now, once people are on the article, in addition to making the content good, you want to have different mechanisms in place to get people engaged. So at the top there are social icons for sharing, for tweeting, for liking, etc. That creates engagement, action. Next up are comments, enabling people to comment, just like a blog, on your articles. That gets people engaged, staying longer on your site. And then you'll see the third arrow pointing to a link within the content itself. So you want to link between pages of your site within the content itself to get people clicking around, Google's tracking clicks. Now also, there's an image gallery on the site. So if you create an image gallery and add a bunch of images to it, put a little optimization in place, and your images will get ranked in Google Images. Traffic will then flow back to your site from Google Images. When people find those images, that's probably where actually half our traffic comes from with this site, is from Google Images. And then we talked about the forum, so I'll just show you videos. You can pull in, you can embed your YouTube videos within the video gallery of your site. So that creates more engagement. People stay, watch your videos, your views on YouTube go up as well. So that's a benefit, and so on. And all the way, meanwhile, you're building your list. You can see our list opt-in area over there on the right. Now, unfortunately, pages like betatips.com that we looked at earlier, those pages don't perform very well in Google these days. This is the page that I'm referring to. These pages don't perform very well. There's not a lot of content. This is not made for Google. So if you do want to dominate Google yet still build a list, you want to make sure to build a high content, a high quality content site, and don't overshadow it with giant opt-in boxes that overshadow the content. So now going back to this slide, because I don't want to overcomplicate any of this, just start with Facebook. I mean, if you're not tapping into Facebook traffic right now, trust me, you need to start. And with everything that we've covered, you know how to do it. And then sprinkle in YouTube, and then connect your Facebook and your YouTube channels, and just watch what happens. You'll see great results, I promise. And then if you're feeling like you want to tackle SEO too, which I'm sure a lot of people on this call do, then you have a case study that you can look at that might help you over at betafishcenter.com. I'm also, like I said, going to give you some software to supercharge your SEO efforts and enable you to build high-quality content sites super fast if you don't have any software like that already. Now, going back to the idea, how do we convert all this traffic into money? That's really the second part of the equation. Like I said, going back to my system, I use a rinse-repeat formula for creating hundreds of profitable niche sites and everything from betafish to organic gardening to home repair. And I set these little simple sites up and then drive traffic back to those sites and make money with them. It's a three-step blueprint. And I want to talk about it in a little more detail right now and show you how it works. Because even if you're already making money online, you can use this and make a heck of a lot more. So you can use it as your main business or as a side business, whatever. It's my main business and it does very well for me. So the three-step blueprint is simply this. Find a hot niche, create an opt-in page with email follow-up, and drive traffic. So going back to this model right here, we're going to walk through it right now, and then I'm going to go back to a case study and show you the real case study in action, or real money-making sites. So